Hi, my name is Patrick and I'm here to talk about NMAT examination. So NMAT is an exam which is conducted for a college called Narsimonji in Bombay, which is among the top 15 colleges in India. So it is supposed to be a good college. So it is organized by the GMAC. It's basically a speed based exam. So unlike CAT, which is more of a logical based exam where you need to think and get the answer, in a speed based exam you need to be really fast and need to be comfortable with the topic. So NMAT comes under a speed based exam, like the banking exam, like the CET exam, SNAP exam. They are all the speed based exams. The NMAT has many campuses. Among them are Mumbai, Bangalore, Hyderabad, Navi Mumbai. The Mumbai is supposed to be the best, then come Bangalore and Hyderabad. So the courses that they run include MBA in Core, MBA in HR, MBA in Pharma, and Entrepreneurship and Family Business. Core program is what people normally strive for. HR is comparatively a new program, but yes, if you are looking out for HR, then it is a good option. And for people who are doing pharmacy and related courses, MBA in Pharma is supposed to be the best. Among all the pharma courses in India, maybe this is one of the best courses for pharma management. So all these courses are also considered by other universities like Xavier University, IBS, SDA Bokoni, but I feel only NMIMS is supposed to be the best, and that is a college where it is worth going. For others, you need to analyze and look at your options and then think about it, purely because the course is a little expensive as compared to other courses. So in that case, if you want to take admission in any other campus, please look at a cost benefit analysis before you take the admission. Also, the course, the whole admission process is a little expensive. So if you're not planning to take admission to NMAT, you need not apply for it. But to be very frank, it is a very good backup option for a CAT. So person who may not do well in CAT but do well in NMAT may get into a good college in the top 15. So I've seen a lot of students who have got into NM but not got into CAT, and that is always a good option to keep a backup option. About the exam itself, there is no negative marking. So since there is no negative marking, it is always advisable to answer all questions. So there are 75 days window, so you can pick up any of the dates and attempt their paper. There are normally 3 attempts. So people who normally write 3 attempts, they start with first attempt quite early, right in the beginning of October somewhere, then maybe second in November and third in December. It is also advisable not to give the first attempt too late, because then if you want to improve your score, you cannot. So I had there was a student last year who scored 220 in the first attempt, but he went about giving the second attempt and scored 239. He got into NM, but there is no on-screen calculator. Like in a CAT, you have a calculator on the screen, but here there is no screen calculator. Cutoff varies from 207 to 210 for NM Mumbai. For other courses in other colleges, obviously the cutoff will be lower in this. So it can go to even 190, 180, 170, depending on the colleges and courses that you apply for. It is a speed-based test, so to be really, really fast. If you look at the verbal section, you have more number of questions as compared to the time that is available. In Quoin, the number of questions are less, but it is quite calculative and therefore it takes a lot of time. Same with logic. So normally it's very difficult to complete the paper in time. But since there is no negative marking, it is advisable to attempt all the questions. And because it is a speed-based test, strategy matters. I'll have a separate video on strategy, but first let's look at preparation. So normally if you're writing a CAT, my normal recommendation is focus on CAT, because CAT has more number of colleges as compared to NM. But if you feel you want to focus on NM, maybe 2 months before the exam, you can start with writing a mock. If your focus is CAT, then you can start writing a mock 1 month before. But if you're looking at other exams also, like CET, SNAP, etc., there's similar pattern. If there's similar pattern, then you can immediately start preparing for NMAT just now, because that will even help you for the other exams. So how do you prepare? Normally recommend you to start with the mock. So at least you know the fairly idea with regards to the pattern of the paper. Analyze the strong and weak area with regards to the mock. See where you're making mistake, where you're doing well, etc. And when you're preparing, focus on your weak area, because remember there is sectional cutoff. Also, because it's a speed-based exam, writing mocks regularly helps. So it is makes sense that before you go for the actual exam, you write enough mocks, maybe at least 5 or 6 minimum, so that you are fairly acquainted with the paper before you go. Strategy is important, and I'll talk about a strategy in a separate video. It keeps varying every year based on difficulty level of the paper, but this is a broad guideline with regard to sectional cutoff. There's a normalization process Basically, what it means is if your paper is easy, you will tend to score higher. If your paper is tough, you will tend to score lower. But when they normalize, they will lower the score slightly for a person whose paper was easy, and they'll increase the score of the person whose paper was tough, so that all are in the same level. So overall cutoff, as I said, is between 207 to 210, depends, differs from the area to year to year. The whole procedure is you write the exam. Once you write the exam, then there is a cutoff given to you for different courses. If you clear the cutoff, you go for the case discussion, personal interview, and based on the combined score, you are given the final selection. That's the normal process for any exam. 4th October to 17 December is the date of the exam. Registrations from 2nd July to 3rd October. NMAT is normally the first exam that start registration. And as there are 3 attempts, you can retake the examination. So they normally have the retake from 5th October to 14th December. Also, it makes sense to register your slots as early as possible, because what happens in NM is that the slots get booked early and some slots are not available at all. So if you have decided your date which you want to write, it makes sense to pick up the date. And advisable first attempt, if you're writing 3 attempts, first attempt before CAT, could be in October, could be in early November, whichever you feel comfortable. Okay, second attempt could be between CAT and IFT. Depends on how serious you are about IFT. If you are very serious about IFT, then maybe not. Maybe you can write the exam before the CAT. But if you are not so serious about IFT, then second attempt can be between CAT and IFT. And third attempt could be after IFT. I will have a separate video for strategy for the exam, and also separate video for different sections like quant, verbal and logic. So subscribe, and I'm sure it will help you. Thank you.